Greetings, seekers after enlightenment. Yes, it's the Irish fellow. Believe me, many people want to see it happen, but the rumors of my death are greatly exaggerated. And I'm back with another rant. This one about the value of isolation and individual freedom. The end of an era may be too much. Let me just say that it is the end of a chapter. My residence at what used to be the place of power is at an end. It was not a harmonious departure. Regardless, I have no hate in my heart for them. Why not? Already turned the corner on that bullshit. I look to those months in the mountains and remember the times of joy, inspiration, hard work, and success. And I have to admit that I adapted pretty easily to that semi-isolated environment. I worked on my own schedule, on anything that caught my interest. My only issue was a lack of funds and frustration over low-quality internet access. So I'm not quite ready yet, but my time of being alone and happy in isolation will return. Outcast. Being alone is nothing new to me, but my current reaction to it is one I had to develop. I grew up as an only child. At times it was a burden when there's no one else around to share the chores with. I was also a latchkey kid years before that phrase came into general use. Now, there are two forces at play, ones that I still relate to. An intense desire to not be alone, and something else. More than once I have said, and no doubt my videos demonstrate, that I am neither average or conventional. I admit that at times, I have the attention span of a cat on crack. Other times, you could set off a bomb right next to me and I'd never even notice. Add to that unusual interest. Literature, chess, and war games are not the usual things teenagers were interested in the 70s. There are just a couple more items to add to the stew. I was the irritating one in class who would always ask why. I broke my leg and had a miserable summer just before starting high school. And one last item I have to add. It's only for completeness, but one will have to admit that it has a bearing on everything else, unfortunately. I happen to be black. And our family moved into an all-white neighborhood when I was 12. Now, for me, I'm very fortunate. Despite an extremely strict upbringing, I was not raised to be a racist. Now, I've examined my own wounds as they heal, and I've noticed that a former injury point will look completely normal, and then the melanin is the last thing to return. So, how valuable is it? So, except for a permanent tan, I sound like and was the typical nerd. All I needed was glasses and a bow tie to be Steve Urkel's dad. And yes, that is what caused me to be an outcast. I guess the modern term is, excuse me. I guess the modern term is educated lame. That's okay. Because the people trying to throw that label on you have no value themselves. And when you're an outcast, you notice things. When you're actually allowed around the real action, everyone knows you're a newbie. So the hazing is going to come. There's going to be public humiliation now or later. And maybe the later will be after you spent all your money on their pleasure. As such, you see the forces that have controlled me for almost all my life. When one suffers from an almost pathological need for acceptance, others can sense that, and they will take advantage of you. Now you think about it and you ask, why would a sane person put up with such abuse? It is an endless search we are engaged in. Some are lucky and can achieve personal fulfillment with a minimum of obstacles. Others are taken off their path by those who exhibit narcissism. Place a vulnerable person in that situation. Now, we have an environment where one person is always giving. Ever more desperate acts of sacrifice are made in an attempt to gain validation. And the one who takes is never appreciative. Maybe for the moment, but very soon it becomes, what have you done for me lately? What happens to you as the victim? Desperation, anxiety, and sometimes abject fear as you continue to live in a toxic environment. Overwhelming dread wells up within you of what the next crisis will bring and whether you can survive. I was still an outcast in my marriage. Fear of leaving and fear of staying, along with manipulation and gaslighting, create a situation where mental stability is impossible. And through all those years of torment, I kept returning to that blue-pilled script. And it was one that used to guarantee happiness. I'm repeatedly told any faults in the relationship are mine, so I'm searching for flaws within myself, within the script that I'm supposed to be following and told that I'm failing at. And I kept getting answers like, well, you're doing the right thing, she'll come around. She never did. Eventually, I received my divorce. And again, enhanced my status as an outcast. With a difference. Freed to a great degree from estrogen-fueled emotional extortion, I am now able to pursue my destiny. But what is it? Years have passed since my divorce and the memories are pretty much an amorphous blur. Now, there were more adventures and lessons learned, some the hard way. At least, one of the good ones was several outstanding encounters, including my former and only friend with benefits. Still, I am an outcast. I'm viewed with suspicion wherever I go. Rejected by people who should at least have a marginal acceptance of me from the jump, and untrusted by people who don't know what to expect. So, this ain't my first rodeo in that kind of situation, so there might be discomfort, but it's a familiar companion. I did make it through the divorce party phase. I proved I was bona fide by drinking 20-year-olds under the table. I proved my hardcore bona fides by puking my guts up, and not 30 seconds after cleaning myself up and getting out of the bathroom, cracking another beer. But that's all extreme behavior that I don't need to do anymore. Because something has happened. An event occurs, and only afterwards do you realize that it was a singularity. Afterwards, nothing will be the same. And this event is one where a name change becomes necessary. The Red Pill, yeah, buddy. It takes courage to come back for a second red pill after you take that first one. But if you use that courage and begin a steady diet of them, you will find out that changes are sudden and dramatic. Anyone who has undergone the regimen of red pill exposure knows this. Shock, awe, rage, and more batter your ego and challenge your id. Your mind, body, and soul are in a consuming fire. Now, when you're in the midst of that rage, it feels like that fire is going to consume you. But there is an important process that is going on. An increasing level of discernment. Soon, you can see that this fire is eliminating impurities. You emerge from that fire as a new being. You have become a phoenix rising. It is the red pill that caused me to apply the label exile to myself. How can this be, you might ask? A man with a pathological fear of isolation now embracing it? I admit that my talents are diffused, but when I focus, it's the difference between a light bulb and a laser beam. It was desperation at first that put me on this path, but as I continued, I realized that the rest of my life will be infused with red pill wisdom. the multitude of reactions to that red pill message and the actions taken afterwards are as varied as the personalities of any group of men. Indeed, that is just more proof of this being an individual mass migration. You come to treasure the mental clarity that comes with red pill immersion. You do not want to be contaminated with blue pill or simp attitudes. Neither do you want to sink into despair and nihilism inherent in embracing the black pill. The black pill is a dangerous path. Take it from one who knows. In my self-imposed isolation, I forced myself to undergo an intense regimen of red pill exposure, psychological nudity, and hardcore evaluation. My videos are on full display where anyone can see my progression towards mental clarity and sanity. It is embedded in me now, that new knowledge that I am homo rationalis in form, Renaissance man in execution. If you're looking in from the outside, it's a hard thing to understand, and it certainly is not an easy thing to do. You're dealing with new information that destroys cultural conditioning. And you have to pick up the pieces and build a new reality from the ashes of your old one. It is an intense personal journey. One can share experiences and relate to others, but surpassing red pill rage is something every man must do alone. The process of spiritual growth is a mixture of discovery, acceptance, and adjustment. An earnest seeker after truth can achieve extreme levels of spiritual power. Focus on virtue, knowledge, and discipline. Following that path, any man can succeed. Now, can one achieve extreme levels of enlightenment in a group? Those practitioners of transcendental meditation seem to think so. Yet it cannot be denied that there are many examples of people who excelled while in isolation. You cannot hear the names Da Vinci, Schopenhauer, and Tesla without acknowledging that they are all bona fide badass motherfuckers. There are surprises that come with the new awareness that is growing within you. Red pill wisdom allows you to know that there is a connection between your own consciousness and that of the living universe. Knowledge of the presence and potential of that divine spark within you helps to expand your awareness. You now know that there are mind and spirit together with body. Development and balance are essential in helping you achieve your maximum results in any endeavor. And so I continue my journey alone. Do I have a destination in mind? But hardly. I don't know most days what I'll be doing the next. I already know the journey is what is important. I also know that in order for Red Pill Wisdom to truly influence your life for the better, you must make it a primary focus. It helps you to avoid situations where you cannot immediately see a proper and safe course of action. When the blue pill is dissolved and the purple pill delusion is abandoned, you know you can seek and achieve enlightenment on your own. It is a lonely journey each man takes, yet one that has immense rewards. One can recognize that knowledge of yourself is the foundation for universal truth. This is a path that contains hazard and one taken with trepidation by many. Yet this is not done totally by choice. Modern culture has destroyed the possibility for peace or happiness in relationships. What began as self-preservation has transformed into self-discovery and exponential growth. There are those who will berate and mock, saying that history must decide if you're a genius or produced a masterpiece. I say that this statement is only part true. You are becoming the best version of you for yourself, not for the validation of anyone else. Shout out to E-Man67. When one absorbs the red pill, it becomes easier to discern truth and reality. But it is important to remember that words and symbols represent an idea presented imperfectly. You must constantly expose yourself to red pill knowledge so you can learn the subtleties, so you can grow, or you will wither and die. Your red pill journey must be a process of continual growth, and when you're alone, there is no interference. I have zero fear of isolation. In fact, I can be in a group and still be alone, in my head. Mental clarity and focus are my tools, and they are available to any man who consumes a steady diet of red pills. As I reflect on what has been expounded here, I am frankly almost overwhelmed. A red pill life is not an easy one. Many detractors stand by. They point and laugh. They ignore reality. Taking the red pill is the first step in unlocking the infinite potential that is already within you. These days, every time I wake up to see another day, it's an adventure. Unless I have an activity planned already, I have no idea what will occupy my time. All those haters try to shame me saying that pursuit of hermit isolation is a sign of insanity. Well, let me drop a truth bomb on you simple bitches. I've done a lot of things and I've seen a lot more. I'm not one of your leftist drones indoctrinated by propaganda and lies. I see the chaos that you have been causing for years, and a natural reaction is to withdraw. You have created a toxic environment for any man. I may not know where I'll be tomorrow, but I'll be damned if I ever go back to where I was. And as a final piece of information, there is a cultural term called the afterglow. I think that the endorphin rush after sex, when you're both sweaty, tired, and happy. You know, we've been there, done that. But there is what I consider a superior state of mind. Serenity. Red pill wisdom helps one to achieve this state. And I have done so repeatedly. I do not proclaim this achievement due to ego. It is a simple declaration of truth achieved while working on this very script. It has been it was a full day and night of labor on this script. It was that intense for me. When you're in a state of serenity, you know that for the moment, you are secure in body, mind, and spirit. That there may be issues, but you have a powerful weapon on your side. The truth. So, brothers, I'm done ranting, and I'm glad I made it before my video time ran out. So I hope you find something of value in this rant. And let me just say, until the next time, when one teaches, two learns.